So hi guys, this is Varsha and you're joining Master Mate. So friends, this video is for all those students who are going to give their board examination, ICC Class 10 board examination in the year 2020. And as you've already seen in the title of this video, in this session we are going to discuss few paper presentation tips for your ICC 2020 board examination. So do watch this video till the end. And if you find this video helpful, then do not forget to like and do share this video with your friends. So let us begin. Well, so the first thing that you have to keep in mind is that always use ball pen, that is dot pen. Please do not use gel pen for your examinations. I'm telling you that you can either use blue pen or black pen, but it is always better to write with blue pen. Now, the next thing that you have to keep in mind is that when you are attempting the answer, suppose you don't know a particular answer, so please do not leave it completely. You have to write at least something, because something is better than nothing. So it is always better to write something related to the topic, something related to the question, so that even if you don't get, suppose a question is of 2 marks, so even if you don't score 2 out of 2, at least you can get at least half marks or 1 marks you can get. So you have to write something related to the topic. Please do not leave any questions in your board examinations. It is important that you have to write something, because something is better than nothing. Next thing that you have to keep in mind is that you must have heard that first impression is the last impression. So what you have to do when you are attempting the answers, firstly you have to attempt all those which you know, and then go for the questions which you do not know properly. You have to write it later, but firstly whatever questions you know, whatever answers you know properly, you have to write that at the beginning, and then you have to write those with which you are not that familiar. You have to write it later on. Well, now the next thing is that your handwriting, it should be legible, it should be easy to understand, it should be easy to read. And telling you that neither the examiner knows you nor you know the examiner, so it is always better to write in a good handwriting, so that it creates a good impression on the examiner. And if your handwriting is good, and even if you are not that good in studies, so you can understand that it creates a good impression on the examiner. And yes, never use whitener. This is very important. Never use whitener during your board examination. In your board examinations, please do not use whitener. Anywhere you are not allowed to use whitener. And friends, you all must be knowing that you don't require any cardboard in your board examinations. Your board examinations, you get a booklet. It is not like the examination that you give in your school. You get a booklet, and you must have done this for your pre-boards also, because it is the practice for your board examination. So you get a booklet and the pages are attached, and whenever you need extra sheet, you can take. So you will again get it in the form of a booklet, and you don't require cardboard in your board examinations. You are not allowed to take cardboard with you. And friends, it is very important to keep your admit card, that is admit card for your board examinations. It is very important to keep it safely, because you must be knowing that in your admit card there is unique ID and index number, which is very important, and every day you have to carry that admit card with you. Every day in your board examination, the supervising examiner and the invigilator and all, they are going to check your admit cards every day, and it is important. And mind you, if you lose your admit card, then it is going to be very problematic. So you have to keep your admit card safely, and I don't think so that you must not have got your admit card till now, because the schools, what they actually do, they do not provide the admit cards to the student pre-handedly. Only during your board examination, just before your board examination start, you get your admit card from your school, and then again after giving your board examinations, you again have to return it back to the school, because the students, if any of the student by mistake, if you lose the admit card, then it is going to be very problematic. So what the schools does, most of the schools, they take the admit card back after you give your board examinations, and again on the next day whenever you have your board examination, next board examination, again you get it. In our time also it was the same. I gave my board examination in the year 2018, so in our school also we did the same, because without your admit card, you will not be allowed to sit for the board examination. So it is very important to keep it safely. So even if you have got your admit cards, you have to keep it safely. And please do write to us in the comment section that you have got your admit cards for your board examination, or you have not got from your school. So do write to us in the comment section. Now the next and the last thing which is very important when you are giving your board examinations, you have to maintain proper speed from the beginning only, because telling you that if you don't maintain proper speed, especially this goes especially for subjects like history and all, when you are giving your board examinations and also for mathematics, you have to maintain proper speed from the beginning only, because at last, you mind you, you are not going to get extra time, you are not going to get any extra time, and your paper is going to be snatched by the supervising examiner. So it is always better to maintain proper speed from the beginning only, so that at last you don't have shortage of time. and you can complete your paper on time. And friends, telling you that each and every single day that you have in your hands right now, it is very important, it is very precious, so please do not waste your time. And telling you that you have your board examination starting from 27th February 2020, that is English at the beginning. So you have to start English language, so you have to start studying seriously for your board examinations. And how is your preparation going on for your board examinations? Do write to us in the comment section. So friends, this was the video. Thanks for watching this video, and if you like this video, then please do give the thumbs up button and subscribe our channel, Mastermind. Thank you.